Good morning, everyone. This is Manjunath. Welcome back to this session. The chapter name is Iteration Construct in Java. So what is Iteration Construct in Java? The iteration statements allows a set of instructions to be performed repeatedly until a certain condition is fulfilled. The iteration statements are also called loops or looping statements. Java provides three kinds of loops: for loop, while loop, do while loop. Introduction. Programs not only store data but also manipulate data in terms of consolidation, rearranging, modifying data. To perform their manipulative miracles, programs need tools for performing repetitive actions and for making decisions. Java, of course, provides such tools by providing statements to attain so. Such statements are called program control statements. Various program control statements are selection statements, iteration or looping statements, and jumping statements. This chapter shall talk about looping or iteration statements along with jump statements. This chapter's outline are iteration through loops, the for loop, that is fixed number of iterations, the while loop, the do while loop, and the last one is jump statement. Elements that control a loop. Every loop has its elements that control and govern its execution. Generally, a loop has four elements that have different purposes. These elements are given below. The first one is initialization expression, text expression, update expression, the body of the loop expression. Let us discuss in detail. So, what is initialization expression? So initialization expression is nothing but before entering in a loop, its control variable must be initialized. The initialization of its control variables take place under initialization expression. Text expression. The text expression or the text condition is an expression whose truth value decides whether the body of the loop will be executed or not. If the text expression evaluates to true, the body gets executed, otherwise the loop is terminated. The third one is update expression. So update expression changes the values of loop variables. The update expression is executed at the end of the loop after the loop body is executed. Last one is the body of the loop. The body of the loop statement that are executed repeatedly as long as the text expression is zero or non-zero from the body of the loop. In an entry control loop, the first text expression is evaluated, and if it is true, the body of the loop is executed. If the text expression evaluates to false, the loop is terminated. For loop. Fixed number of iteration. The following example program illustrates the use of for statement. So public class number, public void print numbers, int I is equal to 0, for I is equal to 1, I is less than or equal to 10, I plus plus or plus plus I. So I is equal to 1 is the initialization expression, I is less than or equal to 10 is the text expression, plus plus I is the update expression. So let us discuss in detail. Firstly, initialization expression is executed, that is I is equal to 0, which gives the first value as 0 to the variable I. Then the text expression is evaluated, that is I is less than or equal to 10, which results into true. Since the text expression is true, the body of the loop, that is system.out.println, is executed, which prints the current value of I on the next line. After executing the loop body, the update expression, that is plus plus I, is executed, which increments the value of I. After the update expression is executed, the text expression is again evaluated. If it is true, the sequence is repeated from step number 3, otherwise the loop is terminated. While loop. The second loop available in Java is the while loop. The while loop is an entry control loop. where the loop body may contain a single statement, a compound statement, or an empty statement. The loop iterates while the expression evaluates to true. When the expression becomes false, the program control passes to the line after the loop. In a while loop, a loop control variable should be initialized before the loop begins, as an uninitialized variable cannot be used in an expression. The loop variable should be updated inside the body of the loop. Following example illustrates the working of while loop program. So in this program, class while loop demo, the class name is while loop demo, public static void main string arguments. Now initialization expression starts. Int I is equal to 1, that is a text expression. So condition is while I is less than 6. So we are going to print 6 times if it is used as is equal to. I is less than or equal to 6 means it will print 6 times. Now we have not used is equal to, so I is less than 6. So output should be printed 5 times. So what has to print on the output screen? System.out.println hello world. So hello world has to be printed 5 times, that is the update expression. So the update expression is the increment operator i++ and the closing body of the program. Do while loop. Unlike for and while loops, the do while is an exit control loop, that is it evaluates its text expression at the bottom of the loop after executing its loop body statement. This means that do while loop always executes at the last. In the other two loops, for and while, the text expression is evaluated at the beginning of the loop, that is before executing the loop body. If the text expression evaluates to false for the first time, the loop is never executed. But in some situation, it is unwanted that the loop body is executed at the last. No matter what is initial state of the text expression, in such case, do while loop is the obvious choice. Now let us discuss with an example. Class do while loop demo. The class name is do while loop demo. Public static void main string arguments. Now initialization expression starts. So initialization expression is int I is equal to 1. So next we are going to do. Next one is do. So print the statement. What to print the statement? System.out.println hello world. So hello world we are going to print, followed by the update expression. So the update expression might be post increment or pre increment. So i++ is the update expression, followed by the text expression, the condition. Now at the end we are going to write the text expression, that is I is less than 6. As I have told in the previous example, here also I is less than or equal to 6 means the output will print hello world as 6 times, but we are not using is equal to symbol. So I is less than 6 is nothing but 5 times the output has to print. So what has to print as output? Hello world. This is the do while loop demo. Here the text expression is evaluated at the end, but for and while we write the text expression in the beginning of the program. So these are the basic fundamentals of for, while and do while. In the next session, we will be discussing with examples of each. Thank you so much for watching, my dear students.